Good afternoon. This is the first of what I hope to be many, many podcasts and presentations. Today, I'd like to talk about something that is very current, something that I'm actually working on with a client at the moment. I think this entire COVID-19 situation has brought out the best in some people. We've got a mad scramble from manufacturers to companies that are developing new technology, new products to mitigate and combat COVID-19. And there have also been several instances where some companies have brought these products to the market without getting the required regulatory approvals. Now, this could be due to lack of sufficient information or lack of knowledge, or simply eager to bring the product to the market quick. So I thought I'll do this podcast to very quickly run over the regulations that govern these type of products. So we have the primary regulation here is the Drugs and Cosmetics Act in India. And whenever I say this, I have people telling me, so the product I develop is not technically a drug or cosmetic, so it shouldn't fall under the purview of this act. Unfortunately, that is the incorrect way of thinking, because the definition of drug under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act is quite broad. I'm going to show you this definition. So if you can see, drug includes all medicines and all substances intended to be used for or in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation, or prevention of any disease or disorder in human beings or animals. It also includes such substances intended to affect the structure or any function of the human body, or intended to be used for the destruction of vermin or insects which cause disease in human beings or animals. And it also includes such devices intended for internal or external use in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation, or prevention of disease. And here's where it gets important. As may be specified from time to time by the central government by notification in the official gazette. So the central government has in fact notified disinfectants as drugs. These notifications were in 1961, 1975. The central government as recently as last month notified us that all medical devices fall under the purview of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. So basically what they've done is they've brought hand sanitizers, disinfectants, whether or not it's surface disinfectants or otherwise, all medical devices, ventilators, under the purview of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. So what does the Act say? So essentially, or very simply, if your product or technology falls under the purview of falls under the definition of drug under the Act, you are subject to the regulations of the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, which means that you need to get all the approvals. So who do you approach to get these approvals? Who are these regulatory authorities? How do you go about getting these approvals? So every state has a state drug control department. So the first step is to approach your state's drug control department and apply for a manufacturing license to develop your product or technology. Once you have this license, you approach the CDSCO. This is the Central Drugs Standard Control Organization. They are directly a body that is directly governed by the Ministry of Health in India. Now they will provide or give you all the additional licenses you require, your import-export licenses, your sale licenses, etc. Point to note is that you cannot apply for an import license under the CDSCO unless you already have a manufacturing license from your state drug control department. I'm just going to very quickly show you the licenses under the center, under the CDSCO. As you can see, you can get licenses for imports and registrations, exports, medical devices. You can get licenses for new drugs, with different combination drugs, etc., etc. All of these have their corresponding, this list rather has a corresponding fee structure for all of these licenses. If you send me an email, I'd be happy to send this list over to you. So the central government also issued another notification, which states that if your product or technology is used to combat or fight or mitigate COVID-19, then these approvals will be fast-tracked. So I've spoken to the drug controller at the Karnataka State Drug Control Department, and I have also spoken to the people at the CDSCO, and they have confirmed this, that if any application is being sent to them which the product or technology is used to combat COVID-19, they are fast tracking these applications, they are prioritizing them. So I would highly recommend that you go through the regulatory process, that it's not difficult. There's just a few forms to be filled out, some documentary proof, and a fee to be paid. And we thank you for your efforts in bringing these products into the market for us. I hope this was informative and educative, and thank you for watching. Stay safe.